Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.3 Developer Beta 1. This is available to developers now and public beta testers either later today, maybe by the time you're watching this, or later in the week. This came in at 2.65 gigabytes for me on my iPhone XR. I've also installed it on my iPad Pro 10.5 and my iPhone 6S Plus. So let's take a look at the build number. You'll see the build is 16F5117H, and this particular build doesn't have a whole lot new in it. It's more that it's laying the groundwork for all of those services that Apple announced this previous Monday. So the first thing is the TV service. So if we go into TV here, you'll see the app is actually all new. So right here, you'll see we have some new categories at the top. We can go into each one of these. We can go through what's next. It's just giving us what's next in our playlist, what to watch here as well. Also a For You section, new and noteworthy, trending, new movies to buy or rent. And then down here, we can actually see maybe some different subscription services and try it for free. So you'll see there's Aerial America from Smithsonian, Stars, bunch of different ones here for now. You can hit try for free and then watch it now. And this is for the TV service launching later this year. And Apple said most of this stuff is either coming in May or in the summer, like the Apple credit card, or in the fall or autumn, depending where you live. And it's going to have all those different features like arcade and things like that. But that is not in this build yet, at least not that we can see. However, they did update, hopefully something that fixes LTE. So let's take a look in settings. Now in settings, you'll see there's a new modem number, and this can vary per device, but the modem firmware should help with LTE. Now I'm covering my MAC address for my Wi-Fi and Bluetooth service, but it should help with all of that. Now speed on the devices seems to be okay. Scrolling, things like that. Settings is not locking up or anything so far, and it seems to be okay. And battery life on iOS 12.2 was quite good. So let's go into here. We'll go to the last 10 days, and you'll see my battery life has been quite good. I'm getting about 8 to 9 hours of screen on time, 3 hours of screen off time, and that's with using Twitter, YouTube, things like that. So it's doing pretty well. It will take a few days to know how it is on 12.3 Beta 1, and of course I'll do a follow-up and keep you updated with that as well. And speed across all of these devices seems to be fine, although again, it will take a few days to know for sure. Now I did run a Geekbench on this device, the 6S Plus and the XR, so let's take a look at that. Now you'll see on the 6S Plus we have 2,588 for single core, 4,527 for multi-core. On the XR we have 4,822 for single core and 10,901 for multi-core. So it's doing pretty good. It's a little bit better than 12.2, at least for me on this device, initially anyway. It seems to get a little bit faster over time, but there's not really anything new. It's more of a groundwork being laid for what's coming later on, and I'm more excited for iOS 13 that's going to show at least the first beta anyway in June. We should see that, and I'm looking really forward to it in this week, and hopefully we'll see all these new features that we've all been anticipating. Hopefully it's not very disappointing. Nothing new on the iPad, just that TV app as well. Nothing really new going on, and that's really it. But if you've found anything, let me know in the comments below. Of course, I'll link the wallpaper in the description, as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. If you didn't, the other one's okay too. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.